I'm going to start by calling the WSA startup function. This will initialize Windows sockets. And I'm going to start first by including winsock. That's going to be include winsock2.h. Afterwards, I'm going to also include windows.h. And I'm going to start my main function over here. First call is going to be WSA startup. I have the documentation open here on the right side. We got two parameters here. First one is the version of winsock that I'm requesting. I'm going to use version 2.2. That's the newest version. Notice that this function gets the first parameter as a word. So for this, I'm going to use make word. And I'm going to pass here 2 and comma 2. And this will request the version 2.2. Afterwards, we have another parameter here that will return back the data about Windows sockets. I don't really care about this data, but I'm still going to pass a pointer here. So I'm just going to pass in a structure. I'm going to initialize a structure over here. And I'm going to pass the pointer, but I'm not going to do anything with it afterwards. By the way, this is a good point to remind that this code is just going to be for fun, and it's not going to be suitable for production. I'm going to skip a lot of cleanup and error checking. After calling WSA startup, I'm going to move to my next function, which will be the socket function, which will actually initialize a socket. So I'm going to open it over here. We have three parameters over here. First one is AF, address family. I'm going to use the AF INET address family. Afterwards, we're going to have the type parameter, and I'm going to use the sock stream type. That's going to be a basic TCP socket. Last parameter is going to be protocol. I'm just going to pass 0 to use the default protocol. This function returns a type that is called socket, as we can see over here. So I'm going to save this aside into socket. And as we can see over here, if I click on return value, if everything is successful, it just returns a descriptor over here that references the new socket. Now I can move on to the next function, which is going to be bind. So I'm going to search here bind. And first parameter is going to be the socket. So I'm going to pass in the socket. Second parameter is going to be a pointer to a structure that we need to initialize with a couple of information. So I'm going to click over here to get more information about the structure. I'm going to use the sock adder in, and we have a couple of things to pass here. Now, to have some help with this, I'm going to scroll a little down here, and we have a little example here. This is the structure that I want to use, so I'm going to initialize it over here above. First thing is I'm going to initialize the family. That's going to be AF INET. Pretty simple. Afterwards, we have the address. This will just be 0. I know that here they pass in this INET ADDR and use the get host by a name. This is just a little overcomplication in my opinion. You can just pass in 0 and it'll use all your local interfaces. That's fine for me. I'm just running this as a basic server. Finally, last thing in the structure over here, we have the port. So I'm going to initialize this as well. For this, I'm going to use the htones function. Htones will basically handle the conversion between the host byte order and the network byte order. A lot of times the host and the network order the bytes in the opposite direction, so this function basically handles this. And here I'm going to pass the port that I want to use. In this case, I'm just going to use port 8080. Now we're done with the structure. So I can go back to the bind function over here, and I'm going to pass a pointer to the structure in the second parameter. Last parameter is going to be the size of the structure. We're just going to pass in size of and then address. After binding the socket, we can move on to the next function, which is going to be listen. For this, I'm going to search listen over here. As we can see, we need to pass in two parameters. First parameter is going to be the socket. And afterwards, we're going to pass in a backlog. This is the maximum length of the queue of pending connections. I'm just going to pass in a magic number here, let's say 10. And that's it for the listen function. So now I'm going to move on to the next function, which is going to be accept. And this will actually accept the connection from the client. So notice that this function returns a socket. This is going to be the client socket. First parameter is going to be the socket of my server. Afterwards, we have two additional optional parameters, the address of the client that is connecting and the address length. I'm just going to ignore both. As we can see, they're optional. So I'm going to pass 0 and 0 for the other parameters. And I'm going to save the client socket that is connecting. Assuming everything is successful, we now have the client socket. And I can move to my next function, which is going to be receive or recv. First parameter is going to be the socket that I want to receive information from. This is going to be the client. Afterwards, the buffer that will get the information. I'm just going to call this buffer request. I'm going to initialize this later. Length, let's just call it 256 to keep it simple. Finally, flags, that can just be 0. I don't have any interesting flags I want to pass on. Now let's initialize the buffer. So that's going to be request, and that's going to be a buffer with 256 bytes. And I'm going to use this syntax to initialize it with zeros. Assuming everything is successful, we now have the request over here. Now the request is going to look something like this. We're going to have get, and then we're going to have slash with the file that is requested. And then we're going to have a bunch of other information. Now, if there's no specific file that is requested, I want to serve index.html. If there is a specific file that was requested, I'm not going to serve anything, just to keep it simple. So for this, I'm going to use a special function that is called memcompare. And for this, I'm going to go here to devdocs.io. And here I have documentation of the C library. I'm just going to search here memcompare. And it's pretty simple. It passes here one address, another address, and the count to compare. And it's going to compare the memory. First thing I'm going to pass is the request. Next thing I'm going to use is the string that I want to compare to the request. That's going to be get slash. And notice I'm putting a space after the slash over here. That is because I want to make sure that there's no specific file that is requested. We're only getting a request for the root of the server. And I'm going to compare 6 bytes. Notice that we have 6 bytes in this string. Now, if this returns 0, this means that the comparison is equal. And in that case, I want to serve the file. Afterwards, I'm going to use the fopen function. This is also a C library function. Pretty simple. It gets a file name and the mode. File name is just going to be index.html, and the mode is going to be read. We can see the modes over here if we scroll a little down. This will return the file pointer. Afterwards, I can use fread to read information from the file. We need to pass in a buffer. I'm going to just call it buffer. Afterwards, we have size, which is the size of each object in bytes. Let's just make each object be 1, and the count is going to be the count of objects to read. That's going to be 256. And the stream is going to be the file. That's called f. Let's initialize the buffer. And now let's go back to the Microsoft documentation. And now I'm going to use the send function to send back the buffer to the client. First parameter is going to be the socket. I'm going to use the client socket. Afterwards, buffer is going to be buffer. Length is going to be 256. And flags can just be 0. And that's it for the server. So I'm just going to save everything. And I'm going to create index.html. Now I'm going to start index.html with a little bit of HTTP metadata. This will start with HTTP 1.0, then 200 OK. Afterwards, we have content type. That's going to be text HTML. And then we can have our text. Now I'm going to save this, save everything, and I'm going to build this project. For this, I'm going to open the Visual Studio Native Tools command prompt, x64. I'm going to navigate to my folder. And then I'm going to run CL, which is the Visual Studio compiler. This will also run the linker automatically. I'm going to pass in my C file, server.c. And also important, I'm going to specify the winsock library, which is ws2, and then _32.lib. We have a little error here. I'm just going to fix it real quick. We need to include scio. Now I'm going to save this, and I'm going to build this again. I'm going to run cl server.c with the winsock library. As we can see, everything is successful. I can just run server. Now if I go to my browser, and I'm going to open up localhost 8080. As you can see, it's working nicely. Subscribe for more programming videos, and thanks for watching.